Well, the war in Sri Lanka saw thousands of civilians killed, and tomorrow that much-anticipated UN report on the alleged atrocities carried out by both sides will finally be published. Unlike Libya, there was never a question of outside military intervention in Sri Lanka's war by NATO or any other organisation. So when is it right or justifiable to intervene? Joining me now, Professor of International Relations at the University of Westminster, David Chandler, and George Grant, who's Director of Global Security at the foreign policy think tank, the Henry Jackson Society. David Chandler, do you see any clear rules about when the world intervenes and when it doesn't?
I don't think so. I think that's one of the main problems with humanitarian intervention. It's not really clear who should do it or what the goals should be or how they should go about it. And so I think that makes it very difficult.
Do you think there should be a set of principles that we all understand?
Well, ideally, yes, but we have to recognise that this is not an ideal world. It's a very chaotic world where countries do what they can, where they can. But the bottom line, really, on this issue is as follows. Governments exist to serve and protect the rights of their own people, not the other way around.
So you shouldn't intervene ever?
No. Well, what I was going to say is when you are confronted with a situation where a government has abdicated on that responsibility so completely that it is actually engaged in the mass murder of the very people it is charged to protect, then it forfeits its legitimacy. And under those circumstances, I think the international community does have every right to intervene.
I think that's a recipe for chaos. Doing what you can, where you can, just opens up international relations to powerful states, dropping caring and humanitarian bombs when they want to. I mean, look at Libya. It's not clear what the goals are, who's in charge, and, you know, different countries take it in turns to drop a few bombs, and it's just going to be destabilised.
But are you saying, in that scenario, when it's clear a government has abdicated its responsibility of care towards its civilians, you still shouldn't intervene at all? Because you'll make it worse.
There's no better way to make a crisis worse than dropping bombs in a country and internationalising it.
Well, with respect to David, I think that's quite a pat answer. And the fact of the matter is, we were confronted in a situation with Libya. It's not like Iraq, where we could have taken more time. Colonel Gaddafi, when he pledged to cleanse his country house by house, did not afford us the luxury
Would you have intervened in Sri Lanka on the same principle?
Well,
thousands of people have died.
I mean, Sri Lanka is a different situation. The point is, you know,
why wouldn't you intervene? Well, just hold on, before we go, what's the difference?
There are issues of what is and isn't possible. And unfortunately, we have a situation in the Middle East in particular, but elsewhere, where there has to be a sense of legitimacy for what you're doing. Not that you yourself feel that what you're doing is right. I mean, of course, that's very important. But that actually everyone else agrees that what you're doing is right. And in the situation in Libya, we had a situation where we needed to get a UN Security Council resolution. We had the support of the Arab League.
Yeah, but we didn't try and
get one.
Given
our history in the region, I think that was extremely important.
Anyone that watches Channel 4 News every night knows there's lots of tragic situations in the world.
Right.
To have an ad hoc and arbitrary blank check for powers to go in and intervene when they want to, would be destabilising. Even if people don't intervene, it encourages a breakdown of stability as different actors try and appeal to America or the UN.
No, but
David Chandler, is it only military intervention that you're against because you think it makes it worse, or any intervention?
Well, most interventions are problematic because even though humanitarian intervention sounds nice, we live in an unequal world. The intervening powers have much more influence, and whether it's a political intervention, whether they just make statements, whether they drop bombs, there is consequences to that, unintended consequences, and those powers that are causing those problems don't have any accountability to those people.
Can I just cut in there? I mean, there are always unintended consequences, and, you know, few things are certain in international relations, and few are still in war. But I think in the case of Libya in particular, which is what we're all talking about at the moment, one thing does seem certain, which is that had we not intervened, there would have been a massacre.
Yeah, but we're trying to talk about Sri Lanka right now and the difference and why we didn't intervene in Sri Lanka when there is a clear civilian threat and a threat to civilians and thousands of civilians died.
Well,
you don't seem to have an answer other than it wasn't practical.
No, well, the point is, it's, you know, there are times when we should have intervened where we didn't.
So should we have intervened in Sri Lanka?
I'm not
according
going
to your
about,
set of rules.
Sri Lanka is not a country in which I have a particular set of expertise. I don't want to talk about a country where I really am not.
So it's not a matter of principle?
No, of course it's a matter of principle. It's a matter of principle, it's a matter of pragmatism as well, unfortunately. You know, we can't just go around intervening anywhere and everywhere. That would be absolute madness, as David rightly says.
David Chalmers, a lot of people will sit at home going, well, what about the ultimate example, the Second World War? You'd have done nothing?
That was a war. That was a strategic conflict. There was interest. There was strategy. There was.
So when it's in your national interest.
All I'm saying is that wars for humanitarian niceness tend to be much more destabilising. Wars, when there's something at stake, where there's a conflict, where you can have a strategy and some coherence and some politics, some negotiations, that is a different world to just dropping bombs if we care for people.
Well, can I just, again, just interject a little bit? You know, let's look at where we have had some humanitarian interventions. You know, in the 1990s, early 2000s, Bosnia, Kosovo, Sierra Leone. That made the situation better.
We will come back to those examples another time. Thank you both very much indeed. David Chancellor and George Grant, thanks for joining us.
Thank you.